Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let me show you how to animate an object over a path in Keynote. So I'm using Keynote version 6 and I'm going to show you a neat animation feature that you've got in Keynote. And you can animate any object, a piece of text, an image, whatever you want. But in this case, let's just do something simple. Let's just put a shape on the screen and let's say we want to animate this star to move around in a path. Now in order to create a path for this star to follow, we need to create another shape. Now for most of these it doesn't make much sense. A line following a path along a line makes sense using the curve here. That makes sense. Even a circle or a square can be used sometimes. But let's draw with a pen and I'll just be able to create a path here and you can hold down and create a nice curve. And I can just create some lines like that. And when I'm done I'll hit escape. So I've got this path here and then I've got this star. I want to be able to select them both. So let me move the path to the back. So now I can select the star and the path. And then all I need to do from here is go to Format, Shapes and Lines, and select Make Motion Path from Shape. And then I have to select out of these two which one is the path. I'll select that one. And you can see it moves the star to the beginning of the path and you can see a shadow of it at the end of the path. And now I can hit play. And when I click, you can see how it follows the path. So a few things of interest here. The original path, that shape, is still there but I don't need it any longer. I can actually select it and delete it. You can see the star is here and I've got the red button there which then shows me the path. So I can see the path remains even though the original object is gone. I can also do various things to change the path now. One of the things I've got here is this plus button at the bottom and I can actually set it to do things like blink or bounce here. Let's have a jiggle here at the beginning of the path. I hit play. It jiggles and then I hit four arrow again and it follows a path. So it's basically doing a bunch of different things in the animation. I can click on the final one here and then I see all the points here and I can actually move them around. A double click on them will change it to a curve, which is rather nice to be able to do. I can also select it and delete one. And I can control click and there's a bunch of different things I can do to the point itself. I can also set something here at the end for another kind of effect when the animation is over. Now this is all going to be part of the animation for the slide as well as other things you may have set. So you go to the Animate panel here on the right and I've got this selected. I could see in the build order here I've got the jiggle that I set right there and also the shape move and I can select each one and I can also set how it starts so I can have it just immediately happen after the jiggle like that. So now I don't have to hit the spacebar or forward arrow again. It just starts automatically. And you also see various things here on the right as I have this selected. This is selecting the animation. You can see it's called a move and I can set the duration, the ease in and out, and whether I just want it to be linear or not. I can also add those same actions here at any point. So an action at the beginning of the move and an action at the end of the move. So in addition to the little special effects like jiggle and such, you could also change something in it, like say the scale, and you could do it from this button as well. So let's scale this up here at the end and we can have it get much larger. So and I can look at it in the build order here and I can see there's that scale there and I can have it happen after build 2. I can even have it happen with build 2. So build 2 is the move and build 3 is the scale. So what's going to happen is it will scale up as it's moving. Now you can actually use those animations to create everything here instead of using a path. So I just want to show you how to do that. I've started here with the star over again and I'm going to add an effect and I'm going to add a move and you can see it creates basically a simple line here. I can put that line there. I can make it into a curve and then I could add another action, another move, and put this somewhere else. turn this into a curve. And then the cool thing is that I could do other modifications here. I could go to this one and I can add a rotation to it. So now if I look at the build order, it will move this first part, rotate, and then move again. But I could add these into each other so that they happen at the same time. So I have this one happens on click. This one's going to happen with build one, so it's going to rotate while it's going. And then this one will happen immediately after. It won't wait for a click. So now you get this combination of things. Rotation and then a move. And you can do that all without adding a shape. And you can use that to better combine things. You can even add, say, right here, have it pause and do a wiggle right there. And I could see the build order. It moves and rotates together. It will jiggle right after that. And it will move again after that.